This is an original French grand poster from 1956 for the film The Inspector Knows the Music. This poster was falling apart, and we put it back together again on a linen backing at Poster Fix. Hi, I'm Chris, and welcome to Poster Fix Studio. Well, today we have another French grand poster. This poster was in poor condition. It was very dry and brittle, and it was breaking at the folds. It also had bits of paper missing along the edges all around. The poster was so dry that I knew that every time I would handle this poster, it would rip and get worse. So I decided to break it up into four sections and linen back it section by section, which is what you're going to see today. Take a look. This French poster from the 1950s is in rough shape. Well, as you can see from this poster, it is all cut in the folds. That is to say, the paper is so dry and so brittle, it has broken everywhere that there were fold lines. Not only that, but on the back there is some non-archival tape, which must come off if we are to give this a real archival linen backing, which would be good for the paper and make it last longer and make it stronger. We are going to mount this poster to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas, which I've already prepared. Now I have to sort of create a judgment as to where each piece is going to go down, and then I'm going to apply the wheat paste directly to the acid-free paper. The director of this film is Jean Josipovici, who was born in 1914 and died in 1992, and he was a French screenwriter and film director. The son of a diplomat, he spent much of his youth in Egypt. He was married to the actress Vivienne Romance, who is in this film. In fact, she's in at least three of his films. After their divorce, he relocated to Italy. Other movies he's made is Dorothy Looks for Love in 1945, Pity for the Vamps in 1956, and Joe Dakota. In the storyline, Harry Louis is a jazz clarinetist obsessed by his art. He would like to match Sidney Bechet. The famous musician tries to give a piece of advice to his fan who accidentally kills him in a fit of anger. With the help of his mistress, Muriel, who has witnessed the scene, Harry does away with Bechet's dead body. But during the gruesome trip, Muriel is accused of being responsible of a road accident. The insurance company sends a young man, Laurent, to investigate. And let's see. It was released in February of 1956 in France. And it's also known as blues, which is why it has the word blues on the title. Le inspecteur connaît la musique. In Italy, it was called Delitto al Nightclub. And in West Germany, it was called simply blues. Well, we've rolled out all the excess wheat paste and we've cleaned off the poster with sponges and we are done. The poster is linen backed. We're gonna let this poster dry for several days because of the high humidity outside, but once it's dry, we're going to restore it and trim it down. Don't go away. We'll see all that after this break. Well, 24 hours have passed, and this has been drying for 24 hours, but guess what? It's still wet.
typical of the summertime, it's so humid this time of year that it takes sometimes 2 or 3 days for things to dry. So let's hope it's dry by tomorrow. I'm going to leave the air conditioning on. Hopefully that will help.
Remember, linen backing makes your posters stronger so that they will last longer. It also provides an archival base from which to do further restoration, if any is needed. It's a good backing to use for framing and other kinds of display. That's what we do here at Poster Fix. 38 years of linen backing vintage posters in Brooklyn, New York. Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of Poster Fix Studio. We hope you enjoyed watching us restore this vintage French grand poster. If you have any questions about the restoration of your vintage posters, get in touch with me by email. Send me a description of your posters, their size, their condition, and send me a few photos, and I'll get back to you with a price for restoration. At Poster Fix, we look forward to bringing your vintage posters back to life.